I have been involved in hearings on the drug issue for 41 years. I'm sure I've been to 100 to 150 hearings, and I hear the same thing over and over and over again. And the problem just gets worse and worse and worse. Over 70% of the people in our prisons around this country are there for drug-related crime. Mm-hmm. It's costing $35,000, $40,000, $50,000 a year to keep each one of them incarcerated. We're spending trillions of dollars every throughout our history in dealing with the drug problem, and it just gets worse and worse and worse. Mm-hmm. And I think drugs are the scourge of the earth, and I think that anybody that deals in them ought to be punished severely. I am for really going after them. Mm-hmm. The problem is the profitability is so great that you get rid of one and there's five more waiting or 10 more waiting to take up the slack because they can make so much money. Mm-hmm. And so my position has been, let's really go after them. Let's do what they do in other countries. A person who's arrested on drug crime the first time, they get a penalty. Second time, a more severe penalty. And the third time, they're gone. Mm-hmm. You don't let them out of jail ever. And if people are involved in a crime that's related to drugs and somebody's hurt severely, they should get the death penalty and we should carry it out. And I know that's a very severe thing to say. But if we're going to go after drug dealers and drug pushers and the people that are ruining other people's lives, we have to be totally committed to doing it because what we're doing right now is not working. We're talking about the 1,980-mile border between us and Mexico. It's a sieve. But if we walled up the whole thing, we could probably keep a lot of illegal aliens out, but you're not going to stop the drug trade. We got the East Coast, the West Coast, the Caribbean. We got the Gulf of Mexico. We got the Canadian border. It's impossible to stop the drugs from coming in. So, and I know consumption's a problem. Everybody says we got to stop people from using them through education. That hasn't worked. And so what you have to do, in my opinion, is you have to go after them hammer and tong. You have to make the penalty so severe that people are scared to death to deal with it. Now, I'm not talking about something like the Midnight Express, you know. Besides, I don't think that story was accurate anyhow. But you have to let people know that if they deal with this, the profitability they make is not going to be worth what you're going to have to be penalized for. Mm-hmm. In other words, even if they make $1 million, they should know that it's going to be worse on them if they get caught. And you make the penalty so severe, they'll stop that. If we're not willing to make the commitment, then, you know, we're wasting Americans' taxpayers' money. And so, you know, after having been through 100, 150 of these hearings and listening to everybody, you know, I just get so frustrated having these hearings. And the one thing I said when I was chairman of the committee, and I am against drugs, I am for the most severe penalties you can imagine for drugs, so I don't want this taken out of context. I mean, I really want to go after them, even the death penalty. That's how severely I think that we need to deal with these people. Mm-hmm. But when I asked the leading law enforcement people across this country before my committee when I was chairman of government reform for 6 years, I said, what would happen if you couldn't make a profit out of drugs? And they looked at each other and said, are you talking about legalizing drugs? I said, no. I just want to answer the question. The question is, what would happen if there's no profit? They said, well, they wouldn't sell them. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I'm not for legalizing drugs, but we have to make one of two decisions in this country. We have to go whole hog after these people and really nail them, as I want to do. Mm-hmm. We have to look at the other angle, because what we're doing is just wasting money. We're putting trillions of dollars over the years into dealing with the problem, and it just gets more and more and more severe. And so, you know, I just get frustrated. Now, the other thing I wanted to do is I was talking to the chairman of the committee. I'd like to go down on the Mexican-American border and take a close first-hand look at this thing. But I hope that you make sure when you put this on the internet that people get the straight answer from me. Make the penalty so severe on drug dealers that they're scared to death to continue into it, to deal with it. Make it. Or you have to realize we're throwing our money down a rat hole, one or the other.